like you to meet Dr. Niles Crane. My husband.
Your husband?
Oh, yes. 6 months next week.
Well, congratulations. You're a very lucky man.
Dump her!
And you know what? You're not going to feel bad about it at all. You know why? Because we're guys, and that's what guys do.
Distressing news, Fraser. Francois gave away our table.
Screw him!
Excuse me?
You heard what I said. We don't need him or his stinky little restaurant. There are plenty of restaurants in town. I say we go somewhere we don't even need a reservation.
Thank you, Niles.
You're welcome.
Yes, you know, if we hasten, perhaps we can catch the first idiot who's a gobble-on.
It's a bit hazy, but starts out in a CD motel room. I'm naked.
Interesting.
Yes, well, I roll over and discovered on my forearm a tattoo, the word chesty.
Interesting.
Yes, and then the shower turns off, and out from the bathroom steps a man.
All right, go ahead, let me have it.
Are you saying that now, or is that a quote from the dream?
You can tell right away the guy is no good in bed. He's so cautious. Look at the way he's blowing on his coffee.
I wasn't trying to cool it. I was simply blowing a foam hole.
You don't even wrinkle the sheets, do you?
They must have sold too many tickets. They've stuck us in these folding chairs.
Wow, right on the hardwood, 5 feet from the bench line.
It's like front row orchestra, stage right.
Oh. Oh, man, we're so close, we're gonna hear teeth rattle when they set a pick.
Oh, it's like sitting close enough to get hit by Placido Domingo's spades.
Not me.
Hello? Oh, I can't talk now, Duke. I'm in the Twilight Zone.
Too. Why is everybody crying? You know how I get when other people cry. Tell me what happened.
I made our father cry.
I'm not crying.
Well, I am. I'm the most ungrateful son there is. I can never do anything for my son.
No one wants to come to my party.
To ask, what's that lovely perfume you're wearing?
Yes, I've been wondering that myself.
It's called Milady's Boudoir. You wouldn't believe what a bargain it is. For $100, I could buy enough to drown myself in.
I've got 60.
Yeah. Is it starting to warm up?
Yeah. But it's a refreshing heat, like those towels they give you on the airplane. Ooh.
I'm not hurting you, am I?
No, I'm just a little ticklish back there.
Well, I guess you are the tough one.
There you go.
Oh, no, wait a minute, Daphne. You missed a big spot right
there. No, that's okay. Because it's all done now, and thank you, Daphne. Oh, a few minutes ago, I was bent over in pain, but now, look at me, I'm running.
Last night, I invited Dad to use my apartment for a quiet, romantic dinner with Sherry while I attended La Traviata.
Mm.
Well, production was just dreadful.
Oh, oh.
In A Force et Louis, soprano couldn't hit the E-flat above high C to save her life. So I got so fed up, I stormed out, drove home, entered my apartment, and when I saw what Dad and Sherry were doing there, I hit the note myself.
You mean they were?
They were.
Oh. What did you do?
Pulled up a chaise lounge and took out my opera glasses. What do you think I did?
I've just gotten a signal from Roz that we're running out of time, so...
I'll skip ahead in our story.
I can't take this anymore.
These women are as inscrutable as sphinxes.
Yes. Mr. Gotti, all they've done is send us the most veiled, cloaked, cryptic messages. Can't they just give us one clear signal?
Well, I'm off to bed. Niles, are you coming?
Curse these infernal riddles.
Niles!
Everybody. Meet baby.
I love you.
You bought a bird. Well, I started to think how quiet it would be around here, and, well, she is lovely, and she's so affectionate.
I love you. Oh.
She says that all the time. I love you too, baby.
I love you, Grandma.
Oh, my God.
What?
It's my supervisor. Hit the gas.
I can't. It might be illegal.
Move or your brother gets it.
Absolutely not.
All right, the headrest.
Off we go.
Okay, now just remember, left elbow in, right elbow up, knees bent, ball the weight on the balls of your feet, okay? Now, just step into the pitch. Oh, yeah, and swing the bat.
I had to go. I'm with a client, and you know what we say about clients.
They always come first.
You are amazing.
Is there nothing you won't stoop to?
I had no idea who I was speaking to.
How dare you impersonate my niece? I've had enough of your cruel jokes. You're fired, mother.
I tried to shake Nigel's alibi, but each witness was adamant. O'Toole.
Faith, and it's true.
Hans.
Your boy.
Miss McAllister.
Oh, Lizzie, yes.
There remained one suspect whose whereabouts had not yet been established. Pippo the Dwarf, a retired circus performer. Exactly. Where were you when the murders occurred, Pepo? Pepo! Where were you?
I was at the movies.
Niles, was that Natalie Spence I just saw you talking with?
As a matter of fact, it was. I've been admiring her all evening, so I steeled myself and asked her if she might be free next week.
Huh?
Well, her lips said no, but her eyes said, read my lips.
Fraser?
Niles, I'd offer you a sherry, but I'm fresh out! Oh!
Shame we have just the one fan.
Oh, really? Yes, that is a shame. The two of us and just one fan. Well, of course, you're the host. You take it.
No, no, no. I couldn't sleep at all knowing you were in the next room all hot and...
hot. Well, I suppose under the circumstances, we could both sleep in the same room.
It does oscillate.
What?
The fan.
Oh.
Niles! Niles! Oh, my God.
Dr. Crane, are you all right?
I'm fine. Just a little hot. And foamy.
You know what must have happened? My hot and foamy must have exploded.
He was a detective, you know.
Maris has changed. She now understands that she cannot control me. I am my own man. I don't actually respond to that. Just a little joke we have between us.
Okay, that means business.
Oh, dear.
I've zipped my tie into your dress. It won't come loose.
Oh, let me see.
What?
Oh! I'm sorry. It is stuck, isn't it?
Isn't that strange?
Oh, maybe some liquid soap from the powder room will help loosen it up.
Niles, there's something on your tie.